Dear plant lovers, I present the Welwitschia mirabilis, an extraordinary plant that Charles Darwin notoriously described as one of the ugliest plants. Yet, I found its tantalizing beauty irresistible and its evolutionary history captivating. In this episode, our host Nicko brought us to an undisclosed nursery in Thailand that is secretly growing masses of these precious babies sustainably from seed. In this episode, you will learn all the fascinating facts and care tips for this elusive desert plant.
Hi guys, my name is Sean. I'm a houseplant enthusiast from Jakarta, Indonesia, and here accompanied by Nicko, also from Indonesia.
Yeah.
If you remember him from our past episode, we covered some anthuriums and some grow lights, and we're here in an undisclosed nursery in Thailand, and we're here to discuss the Welwitschia mirabilis. So Nicko, tell us about these plants and why they're fascinating.
So Welwitschia mirabilis origins is from Namibia, Africa, and then this is the oldest plants in the world. It can be 1,000 years.
As one of the longest living plants in the world, some specimens in the wild are estimated to be over 2,000 years old. These specimens you see in front of Nicko were grown from seeds decades ago at this nursery, but they are nowhere near mature sized yet. Native to the harsh conditions of the Namib Desert, the Welwitschia has remained relatively unchanged all the way from the Cretaceous period. That's over 100 million years ago. To give you some perspective, the T-Rex, Triceratops, and Velociraptors existed at the same time as this plant. It was discovered as early as 1859 by Austrian botanist Friedrich Welwitsch, hence the name Welwitschia, and the species epithet mirabilis means marvelous or wonderful in Latin.
We also protect them and make them more, how to say, like
commercially available.
More commercially available, so everyone can have it, but that is from seeds as well.
Alright, so as the minute goes by, we'll see Nico's shirt gets more and more wet. It's actually sweltering hot right here. But I wanted to ask something about their natural habitat. What is it like?
The habitat of Welwitschia mirabilis is origin from Namibia and Angola, but you can find it more Welwitschia on desert in Namibia. The wild Welwitschia mirabilis on desert is already protected because many people come to poach the seeds. They can survive more than like a month, 2 months without water.
The Welwitschia mirabilis is classified as near threatened due to climate change and human activity. However, due to its long life cycle and remote locations, populations remain stable in many areas. Namibia and Angola has both designated protected areas wherever these plants are concentrated. Indigenous people in the region, such as the Himba and Herero tribes, are reported to have used parts of the plants medicinally, mainly the cones or resin, for treating various ailments.
Tell me about their classification or genus in short.
Honestly, I learned about Welwitschia. They have only one species, so we cannot find like another Welwitschia something or Welwitschia what, and then only one, Welwitschia mirabilis.
So tell me about the basics. Why do they look the way they do? What are the function of each part of the plant?
So basically, if you find a normal Welwitschia mirabilis, they only have 2 leaves.
Okay.
And they are growing from the center of the plants until they die, or until 1,000 years, only 2 leaves. But you can find any other mutation, like 1 leaf, 3 leaves, and 4 leaves.
Okay.
Also the variegated one.
Yeah. So here are some mutations. This one has split into 3. Is this common?
Not common.
Okay.
That's really super rare.
Wow, are they priced more?
Yeah, really more, really high.
Oh, beautiful. And beautiful, so the curls are natural?
Naturally.
Okay, you don't have to like put a curling iron into that. This is the one with 4 leaves.
So this is the another mutation with the 4 leaves, and they have a 4 growth point.
Yeah, interesting, yeah. So this is 1, 2, 3.
Three and
oh, this
four.
Is
that one.
This is quite unique. Two. And this is the one with the one leaf, single leaf
one
mutation.
Leaf. Yeah, 1 leaves.
So is this half the price?
No.
As Nicko mentioned earlier, the Welwitschia typically has only 2 leaves that grow continuously from its base throughout its lifespan. These leaves fray and split over time due to desert winds and harsh arid conditions, giving the plant a ragged, tattered appearance. The 2 strap-like leaves grow outward from a thick, woody, short trunk. This trunk supports the plant and plays a role in water storage, helping the plant survive in extremely arid conditions. Now, looking at the dead center of this plant, most of us would mistakenly assume that all Welwitschias are female, but they are dioecious, meaning males and female cones appear on separate plants. Male cones produce pollen, while female cones produce seeds. Fun fact, the Welwitschia is primarily insect-pollinated, which is relatively unusual for such arid conditions, with most significant pollinators being wasps, flies, and beetles. This plant is not meant for perfectionists because nearly all Welwitschias will have dried, frayed ends on its leaves. The two leaves that the plant produces continuously grow from the base, but the older parts at the tips become damaged and dried out over time.
These are actually slow-growing plants.
Slow-growing plants.
What is the growth rate approximately in inches or centimeters?
On the pot, it's more slower than grounding in here. Like in pot for a centimeters, it takes a month. Okay. And then when you grounding it, it will be more faster.
As a desert plant, the Welwitschia is happiest under full sun. The plant thrives in one of the driest regions on Earth, where rainfall can be as low as 10 millimeters annually. It is worth noting that the Welwitschia derives most of its moisture from coastal fog, a frequent phenomenon in the Namib Desert. Its leaves can absorb moisture from fog, which condenses on their surface and provides vital hydration. In cultivation, the plant may require fog or humidity to mimic its natural moisture uptake from the air. It prefers sandy, well-drained soils that are poor in nutrients. Because its roots grow deep to tap into underground moisture, this nursery strategically uses coarse pebbles and pumice on top, but finer sediments further down, mimicking its natural environment. Its slow metabolism and highly efficient water conservation help it survive long periods of drought. If we want to grow them well and enjoy optimal growth rate, we have to find a perfect combination of potting media and watering. You don't want the plant to grow slowly in drought-like conditions, but you also don't want to rot the roots with overwatering.
Now we are in Thailand, and as you can see from your shirt, the humidity here is insanely high. Very different from their natural habitat, but I've also seen them in like botanical gardens and things like that. Can they live in like higher humidity?
They can live in higher, not really high, but they can live with high humidity, also low humidity. And you can see the character, it will be different. If you see a high humidity, the leaves will be, looks more bluish, mm-hmm. blue, like a blue. And then if you got more lower humidity, mm-hmm. it will be really light green.
Ah.
Yeah.
And they actually like full sun, but here they're grown in like a shade cloth.
Yeah, in a shade.
Is it?
In a shade.
Is but that okay?
Is it? That is really fine. This is really fine as long as you give them the water, mm-hmm. really perfect time.
Yeah.
So, Welwitschia, really easy to get overwatering.
Would you say this is an easy advance or?
For me in Indonesia, I don't know, in yeah. Thailand. In Indonesia, for me, Welwitschia mirabilis is really advanced. Why advanced? Because we got it from Thailand and then we bring it to Indonesia. Mm-hmm. We cannot put it out from the pots. So the roots cannot be sprout from the soil.
Yeah.
If it's sprout from the soil, it will be stressed and dormant. After dormant, it will be not growing well and die.
So it has to come with the soil and
with the soil
with the pot.
Yeah.
All right. So we see a sea of baby plants here. Tell yeah. me how they were cultivated and how can people find the right, you know, sources. And
so they are cultivated by seeds and then they growing from seeds until kind of this size, mm-hmm. Maybe around, you know, 3 or 4 centimeters.
Yeah.
It takes 2 years.
2 years to get this
size, 2 years,
you think, or?
2 years. 2 years with this size from seeds. But okay. 2 years if it's growing really well.
Okay.
Yeah, if you less water or overwatering and yeah. dormant, it will be more than 2 years.
You set it back a little bit.
Yeah.
Now, from here until this age, how many years roughly?
More than 20.
To get 20 years to
yeah.
get to this size?
Yeah, more than 20.
Oh my gosh.
So this one is kind of beautiful, Welwitschia mirabilis. Yeah. They have a really great shape and then character.
Yeah.
Even though they have a dry right. leaves, that will be fine.
Yeah.
Will be fine.
Yeah. And I think this one's very symmetrical. Is that why?
Yes, that's the reason. The great one is you can found on, you can make the symmetric one.
Okay, but usually they are not. I see
they are
around,
not.
They're usually,
yeah.
yeah, they go whatever way they want to. So tell me about how these plants are being displayed.
So If you have a Welwitschia mirabilis, I give you a tip. You need to take it on the tall pot. Mm-hmm. It will be good for the Welwitschia mirabilis, and then you can styling the shape.
Yeah.
It will be looks more prettier than you put it on the short pots.
So as we discussed earlier, the potting media, this is probably big pumice and there's probably small pumice in the middle.
Yes.
And something that's maybe like a soil mix deeper
the pumice,
in there.
Yep.
Okay, and you can absolutely hang them. You can, I guess.
Yeah.
But I've seen people just kind of let their hair like trail along the ground. In the wild, they do.
In the wild, they are in the ground.
And they're just like...
Yeah, just like...
Okay.
So just like this.
Yeah. All right, thank you, Nicko, for taking us here on this amazing field trip. And to reach out, he is at Tujuan Bumi on Instagram. If you want to ask him any questions about these plants or other kinds of desert plants, hound him on Instagram. Hopefully he can help. I wish everyone well, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.
Welwitschia mirabilis is a plant unlike any other, not just for its look, but for its survival strategy. Thriving in one of the harshest environments on Earth, it has persisted for millennia, earning a rightful place as a marvel of the botanical world. Thank you so much for watching this all the way to the very end. Now comment down below to let me know if you would like to see more episodes like this. And before I let you go, I want to shout out to my Patreon members and YouTube members who are financially supporting this channel. For the rest of you, stay tuned next week for more.